The world of Norse mythology is full of monsters both terrifying and fascinating. Perhaps the best known of all is Jormungandr, also known as the Midgard Serpent, as he dwells in the oceans that surround Midgard, the world of men. Perhaps it is his physical closeness to men, the innate fear of serpents that many of us possess, or the fact that he will play an important role in triggering the end of the world, that he is one of the most feared creatures in Norse mythology. But what do we really know about this terrifying beast? Today's film is all about the serpent Jormungandr. If you want to know more about this topic, or any other important figures and stories from Norse mythology and history, visit our website, bkngjewelry.com. blog.bkngjewelry.com. There you'll find posts about all the deities, heroes, and villains that occupy Norse history and mythology. While Jormungandr has the appearance of a mighty serpent, he is in fact from the race of giants. He is the son of the giant trickster Loki with the giantess Angerboda, whose name means bringer of anguish. He was one of three children of the pair, alongside the giant wolf Fenrir and the giantess Hel. Odin, the leader of the Norse Aesir gods, was so fearful of the offspring of such a union of two such dangerous and chaotic giants as Loki and Angerboda, that he decided to put each of them somewhere within the Norse cosmos that they could do the least harm. Hel was sent to the lowest levels of the Norse universe and given charge of one of the Vikings' underworlds, henceforth known as Helheim. Fenrir was tricked and chained up on a deserted island using a magical and indestructible chain made by the dwarves. Jormungandr was thrown into the sea surrounding Midgard, the world of men in Norse cosmos. When the gods captured Jormungandr, he was still relatively small, and they tied him to a pine tree in order to keep him under control, but he was still dangerous. He spat black venom at Thor, narrowly missing him, as the god of thunder warned the others against underestimating the beast. The antidote within the story of Loki and his children connects Thor and Jormungandr from the very beginning, and throughout the story of Norse myth. Thor and Jormungandr are presented as ultimate nemesis. In the Midgard Sea, Jormungandr was able to grow to such an enormous size that he could encircle the entire world and hold his own tail in his mouth. This fact captured his name, Jormungandr, which also means Earth Necklace in Old Norse. The mouth with which Jormungandr grabbed his tail was full of sharp teeth, dripping in venom. His mouth was large enough to swallow a god or a giant whole. Jormungandr has long been associated with the Ouroboros, a symbol of a serpent biting his own tail and forming an unending circle. While this symbol does not seem to have been particularly common among the Vikings, it has appeared across cultures throughout time, being present in ancient Egypt and ancient India. The Greek philosopher Plato refers to the Ouroboros as the first living creature in existence. In most cultures, this serpent symbol represented the circle of life that has no true beginning or end, with everything simply transforming into something new. In medieval alchemy, the Ouroboros represented mercury, also known as quicksilver, one of the key ingredients required for turning base metals into gold. As far as Norse mythology go, Jormungandr's most important role is in the Ragnarok prophecy of the end of the world, but he also appears in two other stories. According to one story, during an unusual period of peace between the Aesir gods and the giants, Thor goes to visit the giant king Hymir in order to retrieve a large cauldron that will be needed for a mighty feast. Hymir, aware of the stories of Thor's immense appetite, slew three of his bulls in order to provide meat for the visit. But to his dismay, Thor ate two of the beasts in just one meal. Hymir then decides to go fishing, as he cannot spare any more of his cattle to feed the god of thunder. Annoyed with Thor, Hymir enlists him to help, sending him to get the bait. He expects that Thor will hunt some small game to use, but instead, Thor slays the remainder of Hymir's bulls and cuts off their heads to use as bait. While this enrages Hymir, the heads nevertheless provide excellent bait, and the giant king catches two whales that will surely be enough to feed the god. According to the story, Thor did not help Hymir with the fishing, but simply looked out over the sea. But when Hymir asks Thor to row them back to shore, he refuses and instead insists on taking the boat deeper in order to catch bigger fish. This makes Hymir extremely nervous, as he knows that this is where Jormungandr dwells. And he also knows the prophecy that Thor and Jormungandr will encounter during Ragnarok. He warns Thor against fishing in these waters, but the god pays no heed. Eventually, something mighty pulls on Thor's line, almost unbalancing the god. Hymir knows immediately that this is Jormungandr, as what other creature would be able to challenge the strength of the god? Despite Hymir's warnings, Thor is undeterred and starts to pull the creature up, readying his hammer to batter the beast. Terrified by this prospect, just as the serpent's body is reaching the surface, Hymir cuts the fishing line, letting the monster sink back down into the depths. Thor is so outraged with Hymir that he throws him overboard and leaves him there. He was probably eaten by the serpent for his efforts to save the world from an early end because of the arrogance of the god Thor. The other story from Norse mythology that involves Jormungandr is also a story about Thor and his interactions with the giants. Thor encounters the giant king, Utgarda Loki, and is challenged to perform a number of tasks, all of which are designed to seem simple, but are in fact made impossible by magic. For example, Thor was asked to drain a drinking horn that was magically connected to the Great Sea. He was also challenged to wrestle an old woman, who was actually a personification of old age. There is no one that old age can bring down. Thor's other challenge is to lift a colossal cat in order to show off his prestigious strength. However, the cat is actually Jormungandr, again disguised by magic. As a result, as hard as Thor tries, he can only lift the serpent cat enough that one of its paws leaves the ground. The giant later explains the ruse to Thor and says that it is a good thing that he did not succeed in lifting the serpent cat, as its huge size meant that the feat may have altered the boundaries of the universe. By far, the most important role that Jormungandr has to play in Norse mythology is in Ragnarok, the prophesized end of the world in which the Aesir gods and giants will fight to the death and cause total destruction of the Norse cosmos. Jormungandr plays an important role in triggering Ragnarok. According to Norse mythology, the apocalypse will be preceded by 3 years of relentless winter in Midgard, the world of men. Jormungandr will become uncomfortable in the icy waters that surround Midgard and make his way to the surface. It may be the movement of his immense bulk that causes powerful earthquakes across the 9 worlds of the Norse cosmos. It is probably these earthquakes that allow both Loki and Fenrir to break their chains and creates a crack in whatever barrier keeps the fire giants inside their Muspelheim, the world of fire. This allows Surtr, the king of the fire giants, to lead an army against the Aesir gods, burning everything in his wake. It also allows Loki to gather an army of giants and the dead from Helheim and lead them into Asgard. Fenrir, now free, runs through the world devouring everything before him, and eventually devouring even Odin himself. This is why it is often said that when Jormungandr releases his tail, Ragnarok will begin. In the final battle, Jormungandr will find himself facing Thor one more time. Thor will fight harder than he has ever fought before and eventually pummel the Midgard serpent to death with his hammer. However, after his victory, Thor will be covered in so much of Jormungandr's venom that he will only be able to walk 9 steps before falling to his own death. Jormungandr will breathe so much of his poison into the air that he will poison all of the 9 worlds of the Norse cosmos. Today, Jormungandr is often portrayed as a monster and a villain, but is it really that straightforward? It seems like it is Thor who actively seeks confrontation with Jormungandr, despite the dangers to the entire Norse universe, rather than the other way around. Also, is it unreasonable that Jormungandr would join his father and siblings in the Battle of Ragnarok and want revenge on the Aesir gods for how they treated his family? The Vikings seem to have recognized this gray area and used Jormungandr as a common motif in their art. He represented immense power and the danger that always accompanies it. He represented inevitability, both of the cycle of life and the eventual end of all things. He also represents courage, as Thor does not turn away from facing him, despite knowing from the Ragnarok prophecy that it will mean his own doom. What do you think of Jormungandr? Is he a monster, an instrument of fate, or just someone put in an impossible position and forced to fight for what is his? Let us know in the comments below. If you want to know more about Loki and his children, Ragnarok, or anything else about Norse mythology and history, visit our website, vkngjewelry.com. blog.vkngjewelry.com. You will also find some amazing jewelry inspired by authentic Viking symbols, styles, and motifs, including many that represent the mighty serpent Jormungandr.